Okay guys, welcome back. Now today I've got the GPS AeroView drone that I picked up from the local department store. Gonna test this one out today. The weather's looking like it might rain a little bit later on, so I'm gonna try to get through this really quick. Now this one here comes in at around $139, and it's also known as the Vivitar AeroView. Now when I went to download the app for this particular quadcopter, it's under the GPS UFO app. Now in the user manual, I scanned the QR code and it took me to a Chinese website, which led into another link which didn't work. So I then typed in GPS UFO on Play Store, and that didn't bring up any results. So I was thinking, gee, what am I gonna do now? I need the app. So I end up typing in Vivitar AeroView, and that one come up on Play Store. So you have to download that to make it work with this quadcopter, okay? Now the app itself is in feet, it's in Imperial, so it's designed for the American market, but that's no real big deal. You know, usually I'm used to metric, but it doesn't matter. So anyway, what I'll do is quickly put my hat cam on here. What we've got to do first is power on the drone, power on the remote, up and down to bind. Okay, the lights are solid, and then what you want to do is do a calibration here, which is this top button. Press that once and the lights are flashing. So what we want to do is just do some clockwise turns until the red on the front goes solid. Sometimes it might take a while with these particular drones. So the reds are solid, see that? Okay, so now we're going to do face down, so the back lights go solid. They're gone solid green. Okay. Now what we can do then is a gyro calibration. I think it's down to the right, or down to the left, let me see. No, down to the right, there's no beep indicator, but the light's flashed. All right, now we want to go into the Wi-Fi. It's already hooked up, as you can see, Wi-Fi GPS, so that's good. Now the layout of the app, it's just got this question mark outlay here, and it just shows you the basic features of the app on one page. Okay, so we go back, click start, and now we should have Wi-Fi FPV. I've already done that. I'll just skip that because I've already done it. This is where you can use your phone with it. Now I'll quickly go through the app quickly. We've got the icon on the left there, top left of the quadcopter. That's your modes for waypoints. We've got the arrow there for follow me, and also the orbit. We have the controls there. Return to home, unlock the motors, and take off, automatic takeoff. As you can see, we've got the telemetry up the top. It's all in feet, so it's all in Imperial. We've got the maps on this side, just there. It's not bringing up the location, I don't think. I sort of got a bit of a map there. All right, so we've got VR mode, we've got the record button, the camera photo button, and the gallery, which is empty. All right, so that goes to a split screen mode when you bring up the app, the maps rather. We've got this gear icon, and it shows you the different modes. So we've got, I'll put that mode 2, high, low speed. This is if you're using the phone to fly it. Parameters are all to do with the waypoints. The map, I can change that to standard. Satellite, I'll put the satellite because I like to see the actual Google Maps. And other is the camera inverse, which you're never gonna use anyway. You don't want the camera upside down. Okay, so let's get out of that. Now to start the quadcopter, it's just a quick up. So there's no down to the outside or down to the inside like we see on most quadcopters these days. And it will time out if you don't take off. All right, so let's get it up in the air, ready to fly. So what I'm gonna do first is press the recording on the icon there, because this only this will only record to your phone. And I just press the takeoff button on the back. Got a bit of a little bit of a squealing noise there from the prop, but pretty steady. Look at that. Let me see what sort of GPS satellites we got. We've got 16 satellites. So it's pretty it's pretty quick. Maybe put it in slow mode. Okay, so we've got Wi-Fi FPV. There's a bit of a little squeal happening with one of the motors or the props. The first maiden flight. So hopefully that goes away. So I can see this seems to be like a 720p camera. 75% on the battery already, so this is going to be a quick flight, guys. What I'll do, I'll send it outbound, just cruise on out there in first rate. This is 190 or 200 feet away. We'll do a GPS home return test. I've got to be pretty quick with all these functions that this one has, so. Okay, so I'll just park it there. It's hovering quite nicely, so let's hit the return to home button and it should turn around like last year's model. It's going up and she's coming back rather quickly. Okay. Landing pad's just there. I won't touch it. Hey, not bad. Very good. That's very acceptable. So that's pretty cool. I'll finish that recording. Okay, so put it back on the helipad here. Let's take off again. Just manually take off. Now that squealing has gone away. Probably, you know, the motors needed running in, so. Start recording again. Actually, let me take a few, see if I can take a, I'll stop the recording. I'll take a couple of pictures. Okay. See how the picture quality is. I think it's taken a few pictures there. Send it back up. Straight up. Take a picture of the college. Just to get an idea of the camera. There is a bit of jello. Take a couple of pictures. Go up a bit higher, maybe. So yeah, it's pretty responsive on the controls. Okay, that'll be enough. Now let's bring it down. I'll try performing the follow me, because the battery's really getting depleted rather quick. This is the first cycle of the battery though. All right, now I'm going to quickly go to here, follow me, and we'll see if it works. I'll get rid of that map. Try that again. Follow me. Follow me ain't working. right now, which is rather odd. Try that one more time. So at the moment, it doesn't have the GPS coordinates of my phone hooked up to it for some reason. All right, let's try the orbit. So it did go back. And it is doing the orbit. Just there. It's doing the orbit. I suppose you can, you can't, once you set it, you can't really go forward or back. Can I go up with the orbit? You can go up with the orbit in altitude. All right, so that works. Now you can turn that off. I did that via the app, but you can turn it off via the button too. I'd like to get the follow to work if possible. Maybe that's an app glitch, I don't know. It's not working anyway. Okay, well it doesn't work today. Maybe I can get it working in another day. Alright. So basically, let's just fly around. I'll put it in medium rate. See how sporty it is. Nice bank turns. It's a nice flyer, just like a normal X8. And this battery, being 200 milliamp hours, is supposed to give us about 10 minutes, I was saying, on the specs, so on the box. Let's try third rate, which is this button up here, indicated by 3 beeps. Okay, I think it's returned to home now. It's at 20%, so I lost control then. Yeah, it's in the LVC status, guys. So that's pretty much going to be the flight time today of the AeroView drone. This is the first cycle of the battery. And I think that might be geofence. So yeah, it's in geofence status at the moment then. Let's see the lights. They blinking, yeah, we've got blinking lights. So I'm gonna bring it down. So I think, you know, with a few more cycles of the battery, it is a fresh LiPo. I should be getting a few on you know, my next few flights, better flight time, so. Down to 15%, so I'm gonna land it myself. Don't want to hurt this LiPo. Try the auto land button actually. Okay, the auto land button works perfectly. And it shut down. Alright. So that was it. That was the quick flight with the That was a quick maiden flight with the GPS aero drone. Get this one at Kmart, guys. This one cost me $139, which is not too bad, considering you get a big brush GPS drone that works out to around $95 US. So you know, these days you can't really get big brush drones like this for under $100. You know, it's pretty rare. You know, as far as in US dollars, there's a lot of those little brushed foldable ones that you know, run on Wi-Fi as well for much more than 100. So yeah, pretty impressed with this one. It seems like it's just as good as last year's model. The only thing I couldn't get to work was the Follow Me, which last year's model done rather well. Maybe I'm overlooking something. I'll have a look at the user manual again. The user manual is pretty simple with this one. It's just a leaflet. But yeah, just take note. I'll put a screenshot at the start of the video here regarding the app. As I was talking about the app for this one, you're going to have to download the Vivitar version of this app to get this camera working and to connect with your phone, because like I said, the one that's stated on the box, I couldn't get it to download at all, even when looking it up manually and typing it in on Play Store, Google Play Store. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this first flight. I'll be doing a few more videos on this one later on down the track, like I did with last year's model. I might try different camera combinations with this one. I'll do a distance test later on, see if it will go to the 300 meters distance like last year's model. And yeah, a few more videos on this one a bit later on, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to comment. And if you're new to the channel, feel free to subscribe. I sure do appreciate it. And if you do, hit that notification bell and then you'll be notified of all the new videos that I've got coming up. I've got a few cool things coming up on the channel, guys, so stay tuned for those leading up to Christmas. All right, guys, thanks very much. Happy flying, and I'll catch you next time. Till then, enjoy your weekend and bye for now.